Zaxby's has been perfecting chicken fingers for 30 years, and now we're going to the sea. Shrimp butterflied and fried to perfection in a perfect blend of Zax sauce and cocktail sauce called Zaxtail Sauce. The perfect southern fried shrimp meal. Woo, saucy! Zaxby's.
Goes by the pseudonym Bo Snerdly.
It's time for the Soul of Excellence.
He is a radio host at 77 WABC here in New York.
The Rush Hour is on the air.
Rush, Rush.
Now here's Bo Snerdly on the Red Apple Podcast Network.
Welcome, my friends. It is the Friday edition of Bo Snerdly's Rush Hour here on WABC Talk Radio 77 in New York. If you would like to be on the program this afternoon, all you have to do, pick up your telephone. 800-848-9222 is how you reach us. 800-848-9222. It is Friday, which means we will try to get to the phones as quickly as we can. And I'm not going to put any restrictions, except if you are beyond, if you tilt the kook meter the wrong way, well, maybe not. Outside of that, welcome in. Also, in this hour coming up, you'll hear it during our first break. You can listen to the series by Noam Layden, our brilliant news director here, Road to the Election. This week, of course, all eyes are going to be on Congressional District that sits right outside New York City. Wonder which district that is. And Noam will fill us in on Road to the Election. Be sure to keep it here and tune in for that. As well, I have a question that is non-related to any political news. It is related to music news. Justin Timberlake is set to resume his tour. He's going to take the stage in Chicago tonight. He'll be in Chicago. I wonder, is he driving himself to the gig? But he is set to perform at the United Center as part of the Forget Tomorrow World Tour. His first concert since the incident. He's also going to perform in Chicago tomorrow night. And then he's going to be back here in New York. He's coming to Madison. He's going to be back in New York at Madison Square Garden on Tuesday and Wednesday. Now, while it doesn't look as though the incident will affect Timberlake's domestic tours, it's still unclear whether the same can be said for the European leg of his tour. He's supposed to appear in court. Now, I have seen story after story about this guy, how humiliated he is. It's terrible. This is, and they've gone, they have been, the press has been trashing Justin Timberlake because he got a DUI. Rich and guys, fellas. Yes, sir. When did Justin Timberlake become a bad guy? Why is everybody dumping on? Look, if I am not condoning by any means DUI, I am not condoning it at all. No one should get behind the wheel when you're boozed up. We all know that. And yes, there's a price that's going to be paid for that, maybe. But compared to the other things that rock and roll people have done over the years, decades, why is everybody dumping on this guy like he's the worst? The kook meter, how offensive. I just got to check the kook meter. Rich, why is everybody picking on this guy? Like, when did he become the bad guy?
Well, I think maybe you're right there. Maybe because he's always had such a good boy image. Maybe they're getting on him for this one so far. Well, it's not one mistake so far. He's made quite a few mistakes, but he's always kind of had this good, you know, Mickey Mouse Club, right? Wasn't he in the Mickey Mouse Club? Wasn't he in the Musketeers?
I don't know. And, I never watched the Mickey. I didn't even watch the Mickey. Yes, I did.
Good guy. Good guy. Kind of
when
image.
Annette was in it.
Good guy kind of image. So maybe they're just getting on him because of that. So I don't
know. He's 43 years old. If this is the worst thing that ever happens to him in his life, you know, okay, he made horrible judgment.
Yeah, well, there was that incident a few years ago with his wife. So I don't know. You know,
what incident? I don't know what you're talking about.
Didn't he slap Jessica Biel around a couple of times?
I don't know. I wasn't there.
I think, I don't know.
I didn't even know he was married to her.
I think that he did. I don't know if they were married at the time, but I think he you know, there was some sort of incident, some sort of, you know, story about that. So pick your poison, I guess. What's worse, this or that? I would take that, but I don't really know. TJ?
People blame him for the Britney thing, too.
Yeah. What Britney thing?
Because he left her back in...
So what? Who wouldn't... be nice, James. He left Britney.
Yeah.
Okay.
And
has anyone seen Britney's behavior the past few years? Would you...
I haven't seen her in general.
You haven't? Her naked pictures have been spread all over every newspaper and across the world.
That's right. We love
this Britney. Woman likes to show herself off.
We love Britney.
Huh?
We love Britney.
Oh, I didn't know.
Yeah. Right? Britney Spears is great. They were all in the Mickey Mouse Club together then, I guess, weren't they?
They were. Really?
So there you go, I guess. So there you go. So
I haven't seen the Mickey Mouse Club since Annette, what's your name, was on it?
I don't
know. Carlos, you're looking like Annette who? Annette. You don't know who Annette is? Annette was like the original, like, she and old Jimmy in the Mickey Mouse Club.
So I'll get you up to speed. Justin Timberlake and Britney Spears were both in the Mickey Mouse Club together.
Oh.
They were in a relationship. He did leave her.
While they were doing Mickey Mouse, they were doing each other?
I can't verify the specifics of
that. Wait a minute. They were doing Mickey Mouse and then they were doing each other, is what you're telling me.
We're talking about underage stuff right now.
I
get off of that.
Who was producing the show? Jeffrey Epstein? I don't know. I wasn't watching it.
So apparently he did leave her, but it was revealed that she was cheating on him with Kevin Federline, who she ended up
having
children with and marrying. And, you know, Justin's album that came out right after that was produced by Dr. Dre, had a lot of comments and phrases that, you know, people could say were linked to that entire situation.
Okay.
Oh, is it like a Taylor Swift album?
There's been some stuff about Justin recently. He has a lawsuit ongoing in which somebody, you know, accused him of using racially offensive language. And then he also has a few things that he's had to answer for.
Kevin! Hold on a second. Kevin, did you know about this? Kevin, did you... Kevin's here. Our program... Kevin... Did you know that Britney Spears and Justin Timberlake were having a thing with the Mickey Mouse Club?
Yeah, I heard that. Apparently, Justin Timberlake, you know, coerced her into getting an abortion. I'm not sure what the whole story is.
What?
There, but I was. Yeah,
what?
That was one of the things that.
What?
Yeah.
Yeah. She talked about it. In
what?
More, and he's come under fire for that.
What? You mean Planned Parenthood didn't hold him up as like some kind of a saint?
He didn't live in those neighborhoods.
Oh. So anyway, Kevin, you know, Justin Timberlake's going to come to Madison Square Garden next week. Are we planning?
I would love to go see Justin Timberlake. I'm sure he puts on a great show. It depends. How's he getting to the garden? Is he going to drive or is he going to take the train? Because. If he's driving, I'll make sure I get there early so I don't see him passing by on the road.
Okay, and now I'm getting text messages. First of all, someone found the kook alert that I did. Look, we are going to take calls. I just said if you tilt the kook alert today, it's iffy. Okay, it's one of those days. But now Britney, she has been abused. Now you're connecting the dots with Jeffrey. Okay. All right. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. So if you're going to go see Justin at Madison Square Garden, give us a buzz and let us know after the show and tell us how it was. I so appreciate it. I had no idea. This is the first time I've ever seen that Justin Timberlake has been like trashed and totally trashed. In the press that I know of. But then again, I didn't know about the Mickey Mouse Club, so what do you want? I didn't know that this kind of things were going on with the Mickey Mouse Club.
Disney, remember?
Okay, let's see. There is a Democrat in the news, ladies and gentlemen, for that is being blasted. His name is Ben Kamens. There is a firestorm apparently happening on social media because this House Democrat staff member has praised Joe Biden after his $8,000 student loan debt was erased. And he's facing even more scrutiny over his social media post displaying his extravagant spending habits. He earns a salary as a staffer of $90,000 a year. And apparently this guy, I mean, look, how you spend your money is how you spend your money. But he went on social media, just got a call to let me know that my student debt has been canceled. This is why elections matter. Thanks, @JoeBiden. He works in the government. He's boasting about taxpayers paying his student debts. He earned $80,000 last year. He's on track to make 90, closer to 90 this year. He posts shots of himself in high-priced restaurants, purchasing high-dollar items. Phone Eats First was one of the posts, showing photos of a seafood tower containing lobster, oysters, next to some cocktail at the Grill from Ipanema, Phone Eats First. This is some high-end Brazilian steakhouse. He posted that he was a season ticket holder for the Philadelphia Eagles. And, yeah, this guy had season tickets for the Eagles.
Why?
And those cost over $2,500 annually. Yeah, he can spend $2,692 on season tickets to go see the Eagles, and yet he's praising Biden for he can't pay his student loan debt back. He also posted several pictures of him out on the town with drinks and cigars, and like that. So this is becoming, he's becoming the poster boy for Biden's student debt. Amazing. What are your thoughts on that? We have a soundbite that we did not get to from Secretary Mayorkas that I would like to get to in today's show. Don't have the story in front of me. I saw the hostess, the black woman with the blonde hair, on PMSNBC, and another one of these Democrats giggling and chuckling about how Republicans are using this immigration effort to fearmonger and to say that we are all just about making people afraid. And meanwhile, these young girls that have been raped, you should hear the response. Do we have that before the break? Do we have Mayorkas? Okay, Mayorkas was asked about this. He was asked about the woman in Maryland, the mother of five, who was killed by this illegal immigrant. And this is what Secretary Mayorkas said. Let's listen in.
I do want to ask you about the murder of this Maryland mother that has been in the news. It's gotten a lot of attention. She was killed last year. Mm-hmm. An undocumented immigrant was just arrested in her death last week. He's suspected of multiple crimes since he crossed the border illegally in early 2023. Obviously, you know, we know that the studies show that undocumented immigrants don't commit more crime statistically than native-born U.S. citizens. But what do you say to critics who blame the administration for allowing something like this to happen? Yeah, obviously, this is something that you hear in right-wing media all the time.
Jim, and foremost, of course, our hearts break for the children, the family, the loved ones, the friends
of who?
Of the individual who was murdered.
Oh, you don't know
the
name.
The woman, the mother.
The woman.
Jim.
The woman.
A criminal is responsible for the criminal act. The criminal who committed this heinous act should be held accountable to the fullest extent of the law, and forcefully so. That is my response.
And my response is that you're the criminal. You're one of the criminals. Because we have laws that should be upheld, and you deliberately refuse to enforce the laws, and you are letting people in this country who have no business in this country time after time, American children and other people, not just Americans, are being raped, murdered, abused, pillaged, and you sit on your behind and deflect blame. You can't even call the woman's name. A woman was killed. First and foremost, I'd like to send my condolences. You don't care. Nobody in your administration, have you called the family, Mayorkas? No. Has anyone from the administration been in touch with this family? Have you been in touch with the families of the girls that have been raped in New York and elsewhere? No. All you do, well, first of all, a criminal is to blame. And now you like this setup from this guy. Apparently the traction is getting on right-wing. Are right-wing people in this country the only people that care? And they put that obligatory now, which is the line. Of course, you know, American citizens commit more crimes than illegal aliens. Here, that's not the point. We do have enough of a crime problem with our own native-born citizens. No one's denying that. Why compound that with criminals who don't even belong in the country that you let in and you pay for? I heard somewhere that it was on this program. We had a caller whose wife works for signing the checks, and she said some of these illegal immigrants are getting up to $8,000 a month. $8,000 a month. Now, I can't verify that. I haven't seen the check, but this is what the caller's saying. We do know that Eric Adams is handing out money like it's water. We do know that the Democrats are handing out all kind of money. We know in California, they have the welcome mat open. Come get your free health care here. Come get everything else here. And yet this guy, well, the act belongs to the criminal. You're part of the criminal. You're the criminal. You let these people in here. Willingly, you don't enforce American laws on purpose. It's infuriating. James Golden, a.k.a. Bo Snurley. 2011.
This is in the mood from before.
In the mood?
This is Justin Timberlake. What comes around goes around.
Hey, girl, is he everything you wanted in me?
This is Justin talking to Britney.
Maybe.
The soap opera.
I definitely know Cry Me a River was for Britney. Maybe this is for the DWY.
Okay, I'm getting an education here. The Britney Justin Love Song medley here on Bo Snurley's Rush Hour, WABC 800-848-9222. Keep it right here. Don't you dare go away.
James Golden, known popularly as Bo Snurley.
This is The Rush Hour with Bo Snurley.
Rush.
On the Red Apple Podcast Network.
James Golden, known popularly as Bo Snurley.
This is The Rush Hour with Bo Snurley.
Rush.
Yeah, on this day, 1975, Captain and Tennille are at number one on the United States of America's charts with a song written by Neil Sedaka. Love Will Keep Us Together. Yeah, this was long before Justin and Britney. Captain and Tennille on WABC Talk Radio 77. Okay, listen, folks. There is... quick history note. Do you know... Does anybody have any idea? I'm just going to do a quick poll. 1787. What happened on this day? Anybody? Carlos, what happened on this day? 1787. Guess.
No idea.
No idea. TJ, what happened on this day, 1787, would change the world, pretty much? Anybody have a clue?
Constitutional Convention in Philadelphia?
Well, you had one word of it right. The Constitution of the United States was ratified on this day. New Hampshire became the state that did it. Now, you may not realize this, but the Constitution of the United States of America is the oldest constitution of any government still in existence. Our Constitution. And folks, we are a young country. No nation has a constitution older than ours. And this constitution has guided this nation. Of course, we've had amendments to it. It has been, and the Bill of Rights was added later, but the Constitution was ratified on this day. We used to have this thing called Constitution Day back when history was taught in America, but that is from a bygone era. Just like we used to celebrate Flag Day on the 14th of June. And all sorts of things related to the founding and the growth of the American nation. Constitution Day. This was also the anniversary of when three civil rights workers were murdered by the Democrat militia group, the Ku Klux Klan, down in Mississippi. Part of the Freedom Riders also happened on this day. So those are just two of the things from our history. Now, speaking of democracy, something happened in California that is probably one of the most direct affronts to the idea of democracy that you will ever hear. I'll get to it. I shall get to it. After we check in with traffic, and after we check in with the lovely Kim Commando. It is Friday. It is Boston Early's Rush Hour, the Friday edition here on WABC Talk Radio 77. 1945. Chris Britton is born. English garage rock band, The Troggs. 1966 goes to number one. Traffic coming up. Kim Commando coming up. Your telephone calls upcoming. Keep it right here on WABC.
But I wanna know for sure. Come on, hold me tight. I love you.
The Rush Hour is on the air. Attention, Ditto Heads. Attention, Bo Scouts.
Rush
on the Red Apple Podcast Network.
1969, this became a top 10 hit for Blood, Sweat, and Tears.
I lost.
You made me so very happy. One of the songwriters behind that song has a birthday today. Motown great Brenda Holloway was one of the writers of this song. Of course, she had her own single career, Every Little Bit Hurts, When I'm Gone, and other songs, including this one. Happy birthday to Brenda Holloway. Curtis Sliwa. Curtis sent me something in the middle of the night, woke me out of my sleep. It's like Trump is coming to Jamaica. Trump is going to be in Jamaica. Now, of course, Donald Trump grew up in Jamaica States. And so, you know, he's familiar with Jamaica. Queens was where the whole Trump thing got started. So what's happening with that? And then I hear, Curtis, you're going to shut down? You're doing something at Floyd Bennett Field? What is going on?
Well, let's start first with Blacks for Trump. 1 month after that unbelievable turnout of blacks and Hispanics in Crotona Park in the heart of the South Bronx for President Donald Trump, they were going to have a rally right there on Jamaica Avenue across from York College. That's predominantly.
Oh, get out.
Right
You're
there.
Talking about over near 150th Street over on Jamaica Avenue?
That's right.
They're going to do a rally for Trump?
That's right. Blacks for Trump. But they were going to Philly tomorrow to see Trump there, so they said, let's put it on hold. When we come back, we'll establish a date so we can have total attention on our rally. And as you know, that is in the heart of the African-American community in Southeast Queens.
Curtis, if they do this, if this happens, this is a tsunami. It's in Jamaica, Queens, on Jamaica Avenue. Are you kidding? This will,
this
is amazing. Okay, Curtis, what are you doing? What are you planning?
What do I always do? I attack the Democrats because they've opened up the borders and allowed criminal illegal aliens in, namely Venezuelans. That we know Maduro has taken a page out of the book of Fidel Castro, who cleared out his jails and mental asylums in 1980, and he saw that he had the goody-two-shoes sucker, Jimmy Carter, waiting on the Florida shore for them, and he said,
hey. Be nice. Jimmy Carter's in hospice right now. Let's be a little bit, you know.
Boy, that's the longest stay in hospice I've ever seen.
Come on, Curtis.
No. Look, nobody wants to see him kick the bucket. But I'm never going to forget the Mariolito boat lift. That if anybody needs to see a movie that is about it, hey, Scarface, Tony Montana, remember?
Al
Pacino. 2 years later, they made the movie. And it caused a crime wave all over America. This is 10 times worse. The Venezuelans are all gangbangers. They've been doing criminal time. Maduro said, hey, look, we either kill you or we'll help you get to America. All you got to do is get to Texas, step over the border into America. Catholic Charities will greet you, put you on a bus, next stop, Nueva York, and you can run this city because there are no consequences when you commit crime. And that's what's happening here and all over the country. Look at what just happened in Houston. These two Venezuelan illegals snatch up a 12-year-old girl, rape her, strangle her, kill her, and dump her in a creek. This is all over the country.
Look what happened in Maryland. And Mayorkas is saying, oh, well, we feel bad for the family of the woman. But it was a criminal act. We had nothing to do with it.
So I'm leading a car caravan in Marine Park, Brooklyn. We're assembling 10 o'clock in the morning on Sunday. And then we're circling Brooklyn, Queens, and then we're going right into Floyd Mayfield, where they have housed 3,000 single, able-bodied young men from Venezuela with nothing to do and nowhere to go at our taxpayers' expense. By the way, federal land, which is illegal, it's a flood zone, and it's time. They got to go. They got to go. I know President Trump has said, elect me and I'll deport them. No, we got to shut it down. They got to go because they've created a menace. And guess what? They're going to have a beach party at taxpayers' expense on July 7th. They're going to the beach.
Good grief.
It's going to be like Jersey Shore, Venezuelan style.
Now, I'm having Todd Benzman on tomorrow from the Center for Immigration Studies on the Saturday show. He's going to join us for a segment. But, Curtis, you just said something that ought to scare people to death if they remember the Mario boat lift. But I got news for you. It's not just, man, I don't have news for you. You already know that it's not just Venezuela. Nicaragua did the same thing. They sent their criminals through. Honduras did the same thing. They are emptying their jails in the Central American countries and sending their criminal element to the United States of America, where they can just walk right in and commit whatever crimes they want to commit. And sometimes we catch them. Most of the time, we don't.
And remember, all these blue states and blue cities will not work with ICE. So even if they catch him, they don't end up deporting him. And worse yet, MS-13 comes from El Salvador. The president there created a supermax, 4,000 MS-13 gangbangers. If the cops see you with MS-13 tattoos, they snatch you up. No trial. They throw you right in the supermax. And all those MS-13 guys are being told, head to the border, Mexico with the United States, cross over, and you will be safe and secure from being put in the supermax. So, of course, they're all coming north.
So you're going, tell us again now, this is happening this Sunday. You're going to do this?
That's right. Rain, snow, sleet, or shine, Sunday, 10 a.m. at Marine Park between avenues U and S in the parking lot. car caravan, we circle Brooklyn, we circle Queens, and then we go right into the federal park known as Floyd Bennett Field, where at our taxpayers' expense, 3,000 illegal Venezuelans are being housed, and it's time for them to go. Time for them to go, James Golden.
And who is going to bail you out when Mayor Adams takes a... Gets wind of this? Who's going to bail you out?
Well, you know, I'll probably be the mini Trump. They will prosecute me to the full extent of the law. They will basically ban me from New York. I'll have to be doing these broadcasts from Topeka, Kansas. But I got to do it. I got to do it. They're taking over our city, our state, and our country. And nobody, the Democrats are just turning a blind eye. And you know what they're saying? If you say it, it's fear-mongering. We had five of these illegals beat up our two cops on Monday. We haven't seen any video. I can't find out what country of origin they're from. They're now playing the game of we're not giving you any information because you guys are just going to fear-monger. And, oh, illegal aliens commit less crime per capita than born and raised Americans. Who the hell gives a damn about that? They're committing crime, and they need to go.
Oh, by the way, you will be glad to know, Curtis, since you bring this up, that the anti-Israeli protesters that have been targeting people here in New York, committing vandalism, that took over Columbia University, a Manhattan judge, district attorney, they let them out.
Yep.
We're not going to punish them. Never mind.
No, they
good
cut,
boys,
they
good
cut,
girls.
Cut loose 30. And remember, that was back in about April 30th. Cut loose. They took over Hamilton Hall. And Alvin Bragg, who loves to prosecute Donald Trump and turn all other criminals loose, turned them loose. And our mayor, Eric Adams, swagger man with no plan, would not name and shame Alvin Bragg. Do you know why?
Why?
He fears.
Why?
He fears that Alvin Bragg, who is the Manhattan district attorney,
ooh,
might also investigate his corrupt administration. So he's taking the code of omerta on his very dear friend Alvin Bragg. Please don't indict me. Please don't prosecute me.
Ooh. All right, Curtis. I'll be reading the newspaper Sunday night, looking online to see what happens and the rest of it. And good luck with this. Tell people again where you're going to be.
Marine Park, 10 o'clock in the morning, the parking lot between Avenue U and S. Don't worry about bail money. They'll probably exile me. But, hey, you'll be able to listen to me as you download your app and on your stream, no matter where in the world they end up exiling me to, like Kathmandu in Nepal.
Boom. Our very own Curtis Lee. Well, thank you so much, Curtis. Listen, it is time for us to check in with the Lou Dobbs report. Yes. Yes, yes. Carlos, who's sitting in for Lou Dobbs today?
Ryan Lang for Lou Dobbs today.
Thank you so much. Let's do that right now, and then we're going to have time for your telephone calls. Thank you for holding, and thank you for waiting. James Golden, a.k.a. Snerdly. Coming back, your calls. Keep it right here on WABC.
Just shoot for the stars. If it feels right, then aim for my heart.
James Golden, known popularly as Bo Snerdly.
This is The Rush Hour with Bo Snerdly.
Rush.
On the Red Apple Podcast Network.
James Golden, known popularly as Bo Snerdly.
This is The Rush Hour with Bo Snerdly.
Rush.
1962 on this day. The James Bond theme was first heard when Dr. No was released. Five saxophones, nine brass instruments, a solo guitar, and a rhythm section. And the music became iconic. James Bond. You know he has a cousin? Yeah. James Bond has a cousin. His name is Tom. Tom Bond. You haven't seen Tom Bond? No. I'm serious. Tom Bond. It sounds totally right. When you see Tom Bond, he's got the part down. Tom Bond. James Bond theme, 1962. Okay, it's time.
James Golden, a.k.a. Bo Snerdly, presents Rapid Phones.
And let's head to the telephone, starting Rockland County. Mike, you are on WABC. James Golden, Bo Snerdly with you. How are you, Mike?
Good, sir. How are you doing today?
Just fine. What is on your mind?
I have to be quick here. So a quick question about criminal liability in regards to Secretary Mayorkas' statements earlier. Obviously, the person who committed the acts is clearly responsible for committing the act. But in the same token, let's say a bunch of dangerous animals escape their cages at the zoo and attack and maul a bunch of people, young kids, everything else. And certainly those animals are responsible for the violence that they caused. But if you find out later on that the zookeeper ordered all the locks and the gates open, wouldn't that zookeeper also be criminally liable for all the acts that
absolutely absolutely for facilitating the criminal act? I'm not a lawyer, but I've watched a lot of lawyers on TV. Felicitation of a criminal act, and also, you know, in some cases, an accomplice to the act. The act is directly, their actions led directly to the crime. I think you make a good point. Again, not a lawyer. Thank you. Margaret in Westchester is next. Margaret, welcome to WABC. You're on with Bo Snerdly. How are you?
Hi, James. I'm okay. I wanted to talk yesterday about women going into the military, but I couldn't get through. I think that probably they should, because they're talking about equality, and they've been talking about equality for so long. Although with the women's lib movement, we still didn't get the equal pay for equal work. It's about 75 cents on the dollar. But I think that women and men are equal. I think they're created differently. They're wired differently. But they're equal because they're human beings. And women do not stand in their own truth. If a woman stands in her own truth, and she's whether she's a doctor, a plumber, a cop, a wife and a mother, and stays home and just does that, it's her truth. And it's good, and there's nothing wrong with that. But we seem to think that there's something wrong with that.
And there isn't. And you have said it. Yes, they are different but equal. And therefore, they should be treated equally. Margaret, I couldn't agree with you more, darling. Thank you for the call. Let us head to South Carolina and speak with Mike. Mike, how are you this afternoon?
Wow, that was a little woman suffrage. Wow. You know, I'm going to tell you a Willie Mays story. I'm a longtime Mets fan. I was at the last series. I was 15. 1973 World Series. I started my freshman year college ball. We lose to the A's. I'm walking through the players' parking lot, Bo. I see a pink Cadillac, black red top convertible, California plates, say hey. My two buddies, it was a cold night. They didn't want, go in the car, you pansies. I got three layers on. 5 minutes later, Willie Mays comes out. And I'll tell you, we chatted for 2 minutes. I didn't want to hold him up. And I'll tell you, man, I was watching the game last night from Birmingham. I had tears in my eyes. I was a baseball nut. And, you know, Willie, icon. And Willie, raise a glass. Everybody, raise a glass to the great Willie Mays and all the other ball players from the Negro Leagues and the Major Leagues, finally recognized. All right, Bo, I'll talk to you tomorrow about music.
Oh, what a beautiful call. Man, oh, man, I love you. Thank you, Mike from South Carolina. Thank you for that. Sandra in New Jersey, you're up next on WABC Boston Early's Rush Hour. How are you, Sandra?
Oh, happy Friday, James. James, I'm worried about the election in November, like we all are, but I'm learning that the Democrats have a very well-oiled machine. Even when I learned about the RNC and the DNC, how different they are, the DNC, they put all their money to the elections. And I'm learning how they're hooked up with all these different agencies like Social Security, like one that I never heard of before. It's called the Biden Education Department. And what they do is they're supposed to give money, funds to studying, but they're not allowed to be used for political activities. But now they changed their minds. They're saying they read it wrong. And now they're going
executive
to
order. Money. You're talking about, look, Joe Biden, I'm sorry to cut you off, darling, but Joe Biden issued an executive order that basically is trying to integrate all of the government agencies in what they call voter education. And all this means is they are trying to weaponize the entire government to do a get out the vote effort. Republicans are, you know, trying to nip at their ankles. Oh, this is, we need more information. We need, look, they have weaponized the government, and they are weaponizing it even more for the elections. This needs to be brought to court now and stopped in its place. You're exactly right, Sandra.
Yeah. So it's a concern, and I hope that, you know, we're like little compared to the power that they have. Like, you know, I'm worried.
And it's not just the power of the government. These people are also using NGOs to do their dirty work, non-governmental organizations. These people are highly organized, folks. You know, I go back to something that I used to talk about in the Obama days. Obama got in, a lot of my conservative friends, all of them, organizer in chief, community organizer in the White House. One thing about these community organizers, they organize their communities. They organize. Joan, in Mount Sinai, you're up next.
Hey, hi, Bo. So, yeah, the Democrats are highly organized like a cancer. And that's exactly what they are. They have infiltrated every agency, and they are not working for us. You better believe it. Another thing I want to say, and I've been thinking about this, I hear about it at night when I listen to the radio. The paper that we're carrying in our wallets and in our IRAs and what we use is just paper. It is no longer petrodollars. Nixon got us off the gold standard 50 years ago. And,
yep. And I got news for you. I want you to do me a favor, Joan. I want you to call back tomorrow. And because we ran the numbers looking at your call on what it would take to get back on the gold standard. I think it might surprise you. But we have to go right now. May God bless and protect each and every single one of you, your families, and your loved ones. Love and gratitude, my friends, for your being here with me and allowing me to be with you. God willing. We are back very early in the morning at 7 a.m. for our syndicated Saturday program. We hope you're here with us, too. Until then, I bid you adieu. Bye.
Long Island is more exciting than ever at Jake's 58 Casino Hotel. Get ready to zoom into some serious cash with Zoom Ball every Wednesday in June. Win up to $500,000. 1 point equals one entry. Two lucky winners will be drawn at the top of every hour from 1 to 5 p.m. to play Zoom Ball. Discover the excitement at Jake's 58 Casino Hotel.
If gambling is a problem for you or someone, please call the 24-hour toll-free helpline at 877-8-HOPE-N or text NY.